Hey guys, we're back here at the Zed shop and we're dialing the sound system for the 240Z. So we're entering the last stages of this vehicle. So the interior is all in. You can see our sub enclosure that we built. It's all upholstered and it has that Aston Martin red on here. We're gonna do another video showing you guys all the details of the outside, but you know, we can talk, we're also gonna show you some of the mechanical bits, but today we're focusing on the sound system. So we have an Alpine head unit, Alpine sub, Alpine amp, and we have 6.5 door speakers from Kicker in here. We like the look of this and the size of it. It worked really well, and you don't really notice them, so it kind of all blends together. And the biggest part of this, I think, is the Alpine PDX V9. I absolutely love this amplifier. It doesn't take up that much space. It's got tons of power, 100 watts per channel, 500 watts RMS on the subwoofer. For most people, this is going to do more than enough. So we're just basically dialing it in, setting our gains and everything, and we're seeing what the car does. So we test with mono pink noise to see what's going on with the sound system, and we want to make sure that we're delivering all the frequencies possible. So by doing that, we're just, you know, it's like dyno tuning an engine basically. I wasn't able to bring in my big RTA because we're in different shops, so I brought in my iPad with the audio control app. And you see the way we mounted it, so we have ABS plastic and we glued it to the vehicle and then we thread in the amplifier to it. So this isn't going to go anywhere. If for some reason you have a water leak, then you have a barrier for it and the seat goes on top. So no one can mess with the settings. All the wiring looks super clean. They, you know, they did a great job with the interior, able to cover everything. And I know no one's ever going to see this, but I think this is a nice touch, making it look more finished like a factory vehicle would look. And here you can see, which is cool, on the other seat, under the passenger side, Dan's relocated that the computer for the 280Z motor is under here. So we have our major components underneath the seats. It's tucked all the way, keeps all the wiring clean in the vehicle and easy to service. And you guys can see that there's two batteries in here. So one, they're set up in parallel. The amplifier's hooked up to the one side and then the rest of the vehicle's hooked up to the other side. So them working together works like one big battery. These cubby holes aren't really used for anything else, so we found this to be a perfect spot to put them in. So I've also gone ahead and done time delay. Basically what time delay is, it doesn't shift the sound per se, but when you do time delay, it removes cancellation. Because if you make the system completely equal everywhere, you might get some dead spots, kind of like two ripples in a pond. So we've optimized everything for the driver's seat. This is usually typically only going to be one person in this vehicle. So I wanted to make sure that we were getting as much sound over to the driver's side as much as possible. Now, as far as the crossovers go, I set the sub up actually a little bit lower, around 63 hertz, and then I had the speakers come down to 63, and I stack it. So I actually use the one in the amplifier, and I set it in the deck as well, but I adjust the slope so it's not super aggressive. The reason why I do that is, like, some people might say, like, well, just send the DSP or the deck and let the amp be alone or vice versa. I tune systems for safety where you can... I might not be hitting their optimum potential, but at least when the user's cranking on the sound system, I know they can't hurt it. Well, let's see what all this dynamat and power can do. So here's another little trick I do when I'm tuning for safety.
Also, I find on Alpine units, the subsystem or the sub-preout is kind of low on signal. So typically, I actually set it to level 10, and then I'll start tuning the gain on the amplifier afterwards. So yes, you could get more out of it, but what I always see is someone goes like, oh, sub, and then they go like this, and you've tuned your system to be at zero gain, and like really like plus 5 is all it really needs, and then they're going like plus 15 on this Alpine. Yeah, that's when you start to get into trouble, especially when you start cranking on the video, on the volume. So what I do is I start tuning at level 10, and I'm already feeding it a bunch of signal in, so I don't put as much signal in through, I don't gain as much to the amplifier. And I find that customers don't blow up their subs nearly as much because they can't push them too hard. So what do you guys think? I think the system sounds awesome. It's not the most expensive gear, but it's not the cheapest either. I think the Alpine V9 5 channel is a fantastic deal. These speakers are super clear, and the bass, you know, with that Type S back there, it's older Type R technology. It hits so hard and it hits so clean. Now a lot of that has to do with, you know, having all the Dynaman in the vehicle, building a strong enclosure and having enough power. But I think it goes to show, like, you can build a custom car and really surpass a lot of the premium sound systems with the aftermarket gear that we're putting into vehicles like this.